Thank you very much. As everybody knows, we have only one planet. And in Institute for Atmospheric and Earth System Research, we are working to understand what is going on and also to understand what will happen in the future. As said, I'm an academician and academy professor in Academy of Finland, and I'm director of the Institute of Atmospheric and Earth System Research. And I have very tight connections to different countries, including China, India, Russia, Japan, and plenty of other countries, and having good networks in these countries. The work what we are doing is that we want to understand what is going on, what will happen on our planet. We have this, we want to understand what when we have more and more population, and population is moving to cities, we have urbanization. What do we need? We need good food, good fresh water, energy, fresh air to really survive, and of course good social networks. But what do we have? Climate is changing. We have challenges in air quality, fresh water supply, food supply, energy supply. We have biodiversity losses. We have deforestation. We have acidifications. We have chemicalization. We have pandemics. And all of these are interlinked. And this is what we want to understand. This is why we need new students, new postdocs to work with us. As we know, we have natural greenhouse effect, and without this, the mean surface temperature will be about minus 18 centigrades, like in our freezers. Now it's about plus 14, and we know that climate is changing, but we do not know the details, and that's why we still need different disciplines to get the basics. Natural sciences, social sciences, medicine, technology, etc. We have initiatives like Pan-Eurasian Experiment, International Eurasian Academy of Science Activity, Science Diplomacy, collaboration with WMO, World Meteorological Organization Global Atmospheric Watch, our own Global SMER Initiative and different infrastructures, and working from ideas to implementation. To understand all of this, we need ground-based data, we need satellite data, we need multi-scale models, and we need all those components. And this is actually what we are working for. We of course need also to have clear and ambitious vision from deep understanding to practical solution. Work with measurements, models, from observations to new theories, and also from research to innovations. Also to economic growth and human well-being and sustainability way of making decisions. We need integrated approach. Since if we think about IPCC, we have greenhouse gases like CO2, methane, halocarbons, N2O. We have trace gases like CO, non-methane volatile organic compounds, NOx, nitrogen oxides, aerosols and their precursors, clouds, albedo changes, and all together, of course, we have quite big radiative forcing. But problem is that still, I can also put here IPCC 2021, observations are fragmented. Greenhouse gases, aerosols, air quality, ecosystems, climate, etc. are typically made by separate research organizations, research groups. And the unique thing in University of Helsinki is that we are doing these in the same station, all of those aspects. We use this integrated approach to actually understand what is going on the Earth, feedbacks, and also to reduce uncertainties and to mitigate and adapt much more safely, sustainable way and effectively. We have a station in the middle of southern Finland with 130 meter high tower. We have smaller towers around. We have, of course, lake, saunas around, accommodation place, cafeterias and lecture halls. And what are we doing there? We are observing more than 1,200 different variables, having really atmospheric earth system, soil science, forest ecology station collecting so many variables, so many results, comprehensive long-term open data. Why? With this kind of data set, we are able to answer questions what does not exist today. They can be questions related to science, related to earth system, related to societal or socioeconomic. But this is what we can do. We can also get, as an example, we can get exactly what is the carbon sink. How much is the net carbon sequestration in that kind of station? Where we take into account photosynthesis, respiration, transpiration, needles, soil, etc. And actually, this is not the only thing. When we use this MER concept, we can make global comprehensive feedback analysis, seeing that whenever we are increasing CO2, we increase photosynthesis. We increase also as a side product of photosynthesis, volatile organic compound emissions, which will make new small tiny aerosol particles, which will then form cloud droplets, which enhance diffuse radiation in comparison global radiation and which enhance photosynthesis. This might be already complex for you. Don't worry. It has taken some time to really discover these things. But the point is that taking all these radiative forces into account, it's enhancing the carbon sink, which means that this kind of ecosystem is much more effective than carbon sink alone in mitigating climate change. And what do we need? We need this kind of pan-Eurasian area from Europe to old Soviet Union towards China. We need area in Asia. We need to understand this kind of megacities. We need to understand Southern Africa and South Sahara Africa, then Amazonas, and then of course these dry areas. And this kind of understanding we need to understand what is going on. We need these big stations. Of course, we have started somewhere. This is when I was PhD student, when I carry tubing around the forest, and we have a very simple way of analyzing those things. Nowadays, we have plenty of instruments like this kind of 3D anemometer measuring 10 times per second carbon fluxes and methane fluxes and other instruments around the place. And if you are visiting Finland, you are welcome to visit also our station. I have published two basic things related to this. One is air pollution cocktail. I was more or less focusing on China in that time, but it's actually working in all megacities. And also that we need to build a global Earth observatory. And we need this kind of observatory to have enough information to meet all these grand challenges. And around the world with different places, and this is also part of our education plan that we are getting scientists educated that who can then lead the operation of those stations locally. What is the benefits? Researchers could find new mechanisms and feedback loops in this coherent data set. Policymakers could test policies and their impact, and companies could develop environmental services and everything in a sustainable way. Inside this circle, about half of the global people are living. And inside this triangle, it's about 10% of the global population. And I'm calling this gigacity. Other gigacity is somewhere here. And there are a couple of other potential gigacities, and to understand what is the difference between megacity and gigacity is one of the future aspects of our work. Something is related to the boundary layer things, meteorology. We want to understand how cities are working, how they are making air pollution islands, heat islands and air pollution islands, and how air is moving there. And of course also to understand that how, by the way, here's 1 nanometer, 10 nanometer, 100 nanometer, 1000 nanometer, is 1 micrometer. How particles are formed here, which means that we need physics and chemistry and meteorology coupled, and how they are making haze particles. And the same picture in a little bit more detail. At the beginning we need with the small clusters, we need sulfuric acid, ammonia, and dimethylamine. Then they start to grow using nitrate and different volatile organic compounds. And actually, big fraction of these haze particles, which is the size here, are secondary MS, secondary mass produced in the atmosphere. And also the particle number concentration, big fraction is coming here. And actually, as to remember, main point, the smallest particles matter. And keep them in the mind, but out of the air where you breathe. And it means that if you want to fix at haze level, we need to start to understand what's happening here. Some words about our education programs. In bachelor's, it could be physical science bachelor programs, chemistry, forest science, environmental science, geoscience, geography, science teacher programs, where one can then go to master program in atmospheric science, which is 2 years, 120 ECTS, and it has started originally 2017, and it's every year we will take new students. And it has six study tracks, aerosol physics, atmospheric chemistry and analysis, biogeochemical cycles, geophysics in the hydrosphere, meteorology and remote sensing. And after that, one can go to eight atmospheric science doctoral program, which is 4 years program. And one can also do it in 3 years. So you are really very welcome to think about to apply these programs. Besides that, we have Climate University. And this Climate University has open online courses in MOOC, like Climate Now, Leadership for Sustainable Change, Circular Now, and different other courses in this Climate University is coming. And this is also easy way to go into our work. And happy to answer questions. I know that right now it's not that much possible, but if people are sending questions to chat or directly to me, I'm happy to answer them later on. Thank you very much.
Thank you for the excellent and clear and visionary presentation. So, Professor Kulmala, as you have said in the presentation, The global grand challenge and its answer is a global Earth observatory, 1,000 or more well-equipped ground stations around the world that tracks environment and key ecosystem fully and continuously. Could you tell us what is the current situation now?
Right now we have stations in Finland, in Estonia, a couple of stations in China. We have negotiations in India. Together with IIT India Delhi. And we have also some stations in South Africa coming in Arctic areas, negotiations in Russia, Japan, etc. It means that the corona time, COVID-19 time, certainly makes it much slower. But right now we have more than 10 of those stations. Still 990 to do.
Thank you. The answer was very thorough and very encouraging.